Hello YouTube, it is your boy B3, back with another kicking trading cards for sale video. Today we're doing the Dragon Ball Super trading card game, collectible card game, whatever you want to call it. Today, we're actually going to look at more than this. I know this looks like just a bit, but there's actually a bunch more off to the side here, because I also am going to start selling four of a kind for Dragon Ball Super. I know I've already shown my Pokemon four of a kinds in multiple videos, two I think, and now I'm going to show you some Dragon Ball Super four of a kinds, and I also have Yu-Gi-Oh! Three of a kinds, because you can only have three of them at three max of any card with a given name in a deck in Yu-Gi-Oh! And it's four in the other two games. So we're going to go into this first. We have this Energy Burst Son Goku Uncommon Leader card. It's kind of a GT. You got the Super Saiyan 3 Kid Goku. You know, there's the front. Neat card. You know, I'm listing these after I record the video, but the video will be up after I've already put these online. So I can't give you prices yet, but yeah, sorry about that. Here we have Power Thirst, Black Masked Saiyan. Really cool. That's the Awakened side. It's just Black Masked Saiyan on this side. Another leader card, uncommon. We'll flop you right over there. Another leader, uncommon, uncontrollable Bardock. You got that big ol' ape Bardock. That's pretty dope, right? You know, just Bardock on the front. Good old Bardock. Goku is big ol' Papa. And we have Power Absorbing Lud. This is a holo of a normal uncommon. I run some Lud in my deck. I think it's actually a really good card. Probably an underrated card just because it's a less recognizable character. But this is a good one. Add this to your deck. By the way, everything without holo comes in a top loader here, and everything with holo comes in a penny sleeve and a top loader. Flop that over there. And then we have Nail the Namekian Ace. A lot of these cards, actually pretty much everything you're seeing right now, I was saving for grab bags when I was going to do grab bags. But I kind of decided against that. So yeah, we have Nail the Namekian Ace. We all know Nail from the planet Namek. Pretty cool, nice holo. I really like how the energy looks in holo cards from this game. Next up, we have another rare. This is a holo rare leader, or foil, I think is what they prefer to say for this game. Rampaging Great Ape Baby. He was really the only villain I liked in GT, I'm not gonna lie. This is kind of more towards the end of his run, I believe. I haven't watched GT since I was a kid. It's really hard to remember. But I do remember not liking most episodes, if that helps. But yeah, that's really cool. The holo on it looks great. So flop that right over there. Then we have Killer Sword Trunks. Yes, this one's holo is a bit more like a super rare. You see it's got the regular holo foil, but it also has the gold throughout. This is not a super rare. This, I believe, is actually a structure deck exclusive card. Yeah, I bought a structure deck. And I was going to use some of the stuff to build with it, but it just kind of wasn't for me. It didn't work out. I decided I didn't like the play style after its alteration, and I just broke it down. So yeah, if you don't want to buy the whole deck just to get this Trunks, I am selling it, and I believe in the future I'll sell the non-holo version as well. Yeah. Flip Trunks back over there. And then we have Bardock Unbound by Darkness. Like a Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. I feel like this might be from Dragon Ball Heroes, because I don't remember ever seeing that, but I also haven't seen Dragon Ball Heroes. Oh no, this might actually be from a video game. But I think Dragon Ball Heroes based on that video game? I'm not up to date on any of this Dragon Ball stuff, I'm not gonna lie. It is a fun game though. This game specifically is fun, not the video game I just mentioned. But yeah, because you know it's the mask, the Saiyan on this side. But I guess he breaks free of the mask and bada bing, bada boom, Bardock. Super Saiyan 3. Pretty cool. The hair was always really cool in Super Saiyan 3. The eyebrows were weird. It's like Cro-Magnon eyebrowless arches. Very odd. But still, a really cool card. So all of those are for sale as singles. Next up, I'm going to show you all the four of a kinds. Starting with green. Here we have a Pressure Assault Super Saiyan Son Goku. Pretty nice. If you want this in your deck, I got all four. Obviously, you don't have to have four in your deck, but yeah, I think it's going to be a pretty good deal. The four of a kinds, I'm probably going to undervalue for sure, just to sell them quick. Like this Vegeta, it's just Vegeta. No special name to differentiate him. Just Vegeta with some really, honestly, tame artwork. I should probably be talking the cards up more, but eh, whatever. And then we have, Energy Power Gotenks. Four of a kind. That's actually a pretty good little card. I would definitely use that. There we go. Off to the side. The next few are going to be Trunks, whose future Trunks is one of my favorite characters for sure. So Trunks, Bridge to the Future. They'll go well in a deck that runs the green scene. You're going to put that to the side to show off the Unyielding Justice Super Saiyan 2 Trunks, or SS2 Trunks. You know, I really like the art on this one. He's kind of battle damaged in Super Saiyan 2, but he's, you know, about to fire some lasers. I'm a fire in my lasers. Remember that meme? Probably not. It was big for a time. Oh, the dog is... Are you crying for a treat? Are you jealous because I'm talking to the camera and not to you, big doggy? Oh, I'll play with you in just a sec. So now, we're going to move into black cards with Quick Blade Trunks. Just thought I'd make the transition with Trunks, you know, in his sword. Really, really nice. This one's pretty good. Really cool card. We're going to put that right there. And that, actually... So, all the Goku I showed you is uncommon, and the Vegeta Gotenks and First Trunks were all common. The Unyielding Justice Trunks was uncommon. And then this Trunks is a structure deck exclusive as well. You can only get him in the decks. So, this is a pretty good one to pick because it gets you the max of Trunks that you can only find in a deck. I think that's pretty good. Then we have Time's Judgment. Yep, this is a common. Five blacks. There we go. Pretty cool. It's got the Supreme Kai of Time. Is that who that is? Once again, very behind. Very behind. Oh, I guess this answers my question. Supreme Kai of Time, World's Protector. This is another common. As you can see here, four of a kind, everything you need, and she's actually pretty good. So let's put her right there. And the last four of a kind, Toa Space Time Unleashed. This is another common, but it's sure easier to buy all four from me than it is to try to pull four, isn't it? Pretty cool. Lots of ones to do with time. You might have noticed these were kind of themed, in a way. So, yeah, you got four, Toa, Space Time Unleashed. Four, Supreme Kai of Time, World's Protector. Four, Time's Judgment. Not to mention four Quick Blade Trunks, four Unyielding Justice Super Saiyan 2 Trunks, you have four Trunks Bridge to the Future, four Energy Power Gotenks, four Vegeta, and four Pressure Assault Super Saiyan Son Goku, as well as Bardock, Unbound by Darkness, Killer Sword Trunks, Rampaging Great Ape Baby, Nail the Namekian Ace, Power Absorbing Lud, Uncontrollable Bardock, Power Thirst, Black Masked Saiyan, and Energy Burst Sun Goku. So that's it. Thank you all very much for your support. Remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. Check out all damn cool links in the description below. We also recently opened Magic the Gathering stuff, like this with a single pack as well. So, you know, this is a really big deal. We also opened a lot of Green Lantern and Batman cards. And we have a lot more coming. So that's it. Thank you all once again for your support, and I'll see you all next time.